I listened to the song and I was like, damn, this is probably the most honest thing I've ever written. And then as soon as the song was done, my entire life changed. That's what my story is about.
What?
Good.
Yeah, this is good.
I wrote Lucifer when I was like pretty much in a really bad place. So a couple of years back, my entire life crashed. I lost my home, I lost my friends, I lost pretty much everything. And that's when I found myself in this cabin a couple of hours, you know, north. I was sitting there in this dark, small cabin surrounded by forest. And I was so confused and filled with all of these emotions. It just poured out of me. I think I wrote the entire song in 5 minutes. I love 80s synth music, 90s R&B, and like modern hip hop, and I try to combine those genres. Me and Simon, who's the illustrator that I work with, we're trying to like build a visual world that we draw people in that is half animated and half, you know, real.
I remember us sitting in a studio in the central of Stockholm, and everyone had fled, you know, like we were there alone. And we made coffee out of toilet paper. We didn't even have money to buy new filters for the coffee machine. And now, when it's kind of turned around a bit, you want to keep doing that. You want to be two people creating music and visual artwork and releasing that to the public.
I'm a producer as well, and I teamed up with Kono. We produced 69 different versions of Lucifer because when I wrote it, it didn't have a sound. We crafted my sound.
No rape.
I grew up in an immigrant suburb called Tensta in Sweden. It's mostly in my teenage years that became, you know, dark. You know, when I actually realized my father was a drug addict. Who am I? Am I Iranian? No, because I don't identify. Am I Swedish? No. You know, at one point I was in a fight and I got all my teeth beaten out. You know, it reached a level where I was like, I have to change. So the metaphor I used to kick it with Lucifer is basically I used to kick it with darkness.